The news cycle is never short of stories of disasters fueled by the climate crisis. Extreme weather events have increased by 83% in the past 20 years. But while it's so important to pay attention to these catastrophic events and the immediate humanitarian impact, there are many subtle and indirect ways the planet's warming is impacting human health too. Tropical vector-borne diseases like dengue fever and malaria are on the rise and could soon be found in cooler climates. And yellow fever is predicted to reach new parts of the world because of increased rainfall and therefore larger mosquito populations. Meanwhile, the emergence of COVID-19 highlighted the fragile balance between animal and human health and the need for holistic health systems.
In a lot of ways, you know, we've been very, very aware of this COVID pandemic, but we've been much less aware of a sort of much quieter pandemic that involves the sort of erosion of human health as a result of the degradation of our planet's life support systems. And when you start to take this lens of thinking about how anthropogenic environmental change is affecting health, what you very quickly start to see is that every dimension of health is being extensively impacted by the transformation of our planet's natural systems.
Another key issue is the rising threat of antimicrobial resistance. There's a link between disease resistance in animals and humans because it means antimicrobial resistance gets into the food chain.
There are several drivers of antimicrobial resistance, one of which we know is really the consumption and the misuse, overuse of antimicrobials in human populations. Taking it on the other side, in the agriculture sector, we have similar things where farmers and livestock producers use antimicrobials to prevent infections in the animals or in the head of the animals. And thinking about runoffs from pharmaceuticals, that's medicines or antimicrobials producers, just sending off the waste into the rivers or the lakes and not properly treating it.
Another problem is that despite growing recognition of the crucial link between them, health and climate are still treated as separate fields in global development. That means funding is all too often restricted to one or the other. To deal with these multifaceted issues, experts in planetary health are calling for people to work together.
There's no dimension of health that is not being impacted. And yet, if you don't bring this lens, you account for all of that morbidity and mortality as that's heart disease, or that's stroke, or that's malaria. And yes, it is those things, but what's actually driving those is our transformation of environmental conditions. So now you're getting malaria in the East African highlands, or chikungunya fever moving into Europe where you never used to get it. So it's through this lens that you start to account for all of that burden of disease in a very different way than you would if you didn't bring the lens to it.
Solutions could include environmental projects designed with health co-benefits in mind. Something as simple as cities providing more cycle lanes and improving public transit to reduce pollution, for example. Innovations in telehealth could also help to ensure some healthcare can continue during a crisis. We also need to look at medical supply chains and have backup systems in place to make sure health systems are future-proofed amid unpredictable weather. In the world of science, it means more funding for research to predict new disease threats and develop a response.
What we are really advocating for is all countries really need to endorse and embrace and actually operationalize the One Health approach, in which human, animal, and environmental sectors can work jointly to raise awareness, and they can work together to implement control and preparedness programs.
The challenge of the climate crisis and the multiple ways it will affect human health certainly can't be ignored, and people working together across both fields will be key to addressing the problems ahead. Join us to find out more in a new series from Devex, Planet Health.